Every Who down in Whoville liked Christmas a lot.
But the Grinch, who lived just north of Whoville, did not. The Grinch hated Christmas the whole Christmas season.
Oh, please don't ask why. No one quite knows the reason. It could be, perhaps, that his shoes were too tight. It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right. But I think that the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small. But whatever the reason, his heart or his shoes, he stood there on Christmas Eve, hating the Whos. Staring down from his cave with a sour, grinchy frown. Warm, lighted windows below in their town. For he knew every Who down in Whoville beneath was busy now, hanging a holly Who wreath.
Trim up the tree with Christmas stuff, a bingo ball and hoo hoo flop. Trim up the town with goo-hoo gums and gizzle things and wands.
Trim every blessed window and trim every blessed door. Hang up hoo-hoo-hoo.
Then run out and get some more.
Hang bandukas on the ceilings, pile bandunas on the floor.
Trim every blessed needle on the blessed Christmas tree. Christmas comes tomorrow.
Trim you, trim me. Trim up your pets with Buzzle Buzz, and Ripper Bloops, and Buzzle Buzz. Trim up your uncle and your aunt with yards of Hoopa plant.
Trim every house in Whoville from the cellar to the roof. Hang up a mile of dapplers
and 3 miles of snappers too.
Hang dang donglers on the bathtub. Trim the occupant with blue.
To every home in Whoville and to every blessed Who, Christmas comes tomorrow.
Trim me, trim you. Trim up the tree with Christmas stuff, a bingo ball and hoop hoop flop. Trim up the town with goo-hoo gums and ears.
And they're hanging their stockings, he snarled with a sneer. Tomorrow is Christmas. It's practically here. Then he growled with his Grinch fingers, nervously drumming. I must find some way to keep Christmas from coming. Or tomorrow, I know. All those Who girls and boys will wake bright and early. They'll rush for their toys and then... Oh, the noise, oh, the noise, 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 noise. There's one thing I hate. All the noise, 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 noise. And their shrieks, squeaks and squeals racing round on their wheels. They'll dance with jing-tinglers tied onto their heels. They'll blow their flu-flubas and bang their tartinkas. They'll blow their hoo-hoobas, they'll bang their garskinkas. They'll beat their trum-tookas, they'll slam their slu-slunkas. They'll beat their blum-blukas, they'll wham their hoo-wonkas. And they play noisy games like Zuzita Kaze, a roller skate type of lacrosse and croquet. And then they'll make ear-splitting noises to looks on their great big electro-hoo-cardio schnooks. Then the Whos, young and old, will sit down to a feast. And they'll feast, and they'll feast. And they'll feast, 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 feast. They'll feast on Who pudding and rare Who roast beast. Raw roast beast is a feast I can't stand in the least. And then they'll do something I hate most of all. Every who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, will stand close together with Christmas bells ringing. They'll stand hand in hand. Those who's will start singing.
Grinch thought of this Who Christmas Sing, the more the Grinch thought,
I must stop this whole thing. Why, for 53 years I put up with it now. I must stop Christmas from coming. But how?
Then he got an idea. An awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea.
I know just what to do, the Grinch laughed in his throat. I'll make a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat.
And he chuckled and clucked.
What a great Grinchy trick. With this coat and this hat, I'll look just like Saint Nick. All I need is a reindeer.
The Grinch looked around, but since reindeer are scarce, there was none to be found. Did that stop the Grinch?
Ha!
The Grinch simply said,
if I can't find a reindeer, I'll make one instead.
So he took his dog Max, and he took some black thread, and he tied a big horn on the top of his head. Then he loaded some bags and some old empty sacks on a ramshackle sleigh, and he whistled for Max. And the Grinch said,
get up!
And the sleigh started down toward the homes where the Whos lay a-snooze in their town. Their windows were dark. No one knew he was there. All the Whos were all dreaming sweet dreams without care. When he came to the first little house on the square.
This is stop number one,
the old Grinchy Claus hissed as he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist. Then he slid down the chimney, a rather tight pinch. But if Santa could do it then, so could the Grinch. He got stuck only once, for a minute or two. Then he stuck his head out of the fireplace flue where the little Who stockings hung all in a row.
These stockings, he grinched, are the first things to go.
Slithered and slunk with a smile most unpleasant around the whole room, and he took every present. Popguns, pampoonas, pantookas and drums, checkerboards, bisselbigs, popcorn and plums. Then he stuffed them in bags. Then the Grinch very nimbly stuffed all the bags one by one up the chimbley.
a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus, you're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. You're a monster, Mr. Grinch. Your heart's an empty hole. Your brain is full of spiders. You've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch. I wouldn't touch you with a 39 and a half foot pole. You're a vile one, Mr. Grinch. You have termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile, Mr. Grinch. Given the choice between the two of you, I'd take the seasick crocodile.
Then he slunk to the icebox. He took the Who's feast. He took the Who pudding. He took the roast beast. He cleaned out the icebox as quick as a flash. Why, that Grinch even took the last can of Who hash. Then he stuffed all the food up the chimney with glee. And now, grinned the Grinch, I will stuff up the tree. As the Grinch took the tree, as he started to shove, he heard a small sound like the coo of a dove. He turned around fast and he saw a small Who, little Cindy Lou Who, who was no more than two. She stared at the Grinch and said, Santa Claus, why? Why are you taking our Christmas tree? Why? But you know, that old Grinch was so smart and so slick, he thought up a lie and he thought it up quick.
Why, my sweet little tot,
the fake Santa Claus lied.
There's a light on this tree that won't light on one side. So I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there, then I'll bring it back here.
And his fib fooled the child. Then he patted her head and he got her a drink and he sent her to bed. And when Cindy Lou Who was in bed with her cup, he crept to the chimney and stuffed the tree up. Then he went up the chimney himself, the old liar, and the last thing he took was the log for their fire. On their walls he left nothing but hooks and some wire. And the one speck of food that he left in the house was a crumb that was even too small for a mouse. Then he did the same thing to the other Who's houses, leaving crumbs much too small for the other Who's mouses.
You're a foul one, Mr. Grinch. You're a nasty, wasty skunk. Your heart is full of unwashed socks. Your soul is full of gunk, Mr. Grinch. The three words that best describe you are as follows, and I quote, stink, stank, stunk. You're a rotter, Mr. Grinch. You're the king of sinful sots. Your heart's a dead tomato splotched with moldy purple spots, Mr. Grinch. Your soul is an appalling dump heap, overflowing with the most disgraceful assortment of deplorable rubbish imaginable, mangled up in tangled up knots. You nauseate me, Mr. Grinch, with a nauseous super nos. You're a crooked, jerky jockey, and you drive a crooked horse, Mr. Grinch. You're a three-decker sauerkraut and toadstool sandwich with arsenic sauce.
It was a quarter of dawn, all the Who's still abed, all the Who's still a snooze, when he packed up his sled. Packed it up with their presents, their ribbons, their wrappings, their snoof and their fuzzles, their tringlers and trappings. 10,000 feet up, up the side of Mount Crumpet, he rode with his load to the tip-top to dump it.
The Who's,
he was grinchily humming.
They're finding out now that no Christmas is coming. They're just waking up. I know just what they'll do. Their mouths will hang open a minute or two. Then the Who's down in Whoville will all cry, boo-hoo. That's a noise, grinned the Grinch, that I simply must hear.
He paused, and the Grinch put a hand to his ear. And he did hear a sound rising over the snow. It started in low, then it started to grow. This sound wasn't sad. Why, this sound sounded glad. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing. Without any presents at all. He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came. Somehow or other, it came just the same. And the Grinch, with his Grinch feet, ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling.
How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags.
He puzzled and puzzled till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before.
Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more.
And what happened then? Well, in Whoville, they say, that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day.
And then the true meaning of Christmas came through, and the Grinch found the strength of 10 Grinches. Plus 2. And now that his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whizzed with his load through the bright morning light. With a smile in his soul, he descended Mount Crumpet, cheerily blowing ho, ho on his trumpet. He rode into Whoville, he brought back their toys, he brought back their floof to the Who girls and boys. He brought back their snoof and their tringlers and fuzzles, brought back their pantookas, their dafflers and wuzzles. He brought everything back, all the food for the feast. And he himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast. Welcome, Christmas. Bring your cheer. Cheer to all Who's far and near. Christmas Day is in our grasp, so long as we have hands to clasp.
Christmas Day will always be just as long as we have breathed. Welcome Christmas while we stand heart to heart and hand in hand.